marching in defiance and making a statement in front of the Chinese embassy in Manila. These activists want to remind Beijing of what happened 5 years ago when it lost in a legal battle on the world stage. In 2012, Scarborough Shoal was forcibly seized by the Chinese military, prompting then-President Benigno Aquino to file a case at the International Court in The Hague. 4 years later, the tribunal invalidated China's so-called historical nine-dash claim of most of the South China Sea. A smaller country standing up to a superpower was seen as unprecedented.
For as long as nations abide by the rule of law and not of military might, the award is the North Star that will keep us on course in the present and that will point us back to the right direction in the future should we, in a moment of weakness or inaction, lose our way.
But the legal victory had little impact on China's behavior. In the past few years, China even increased its presence in areas controlled by the Philippines and other countries, with what are described as fishing militias believed to be connected to the Chinese army. And it's also expanded its reclamations of islands and reefs already deemed illegal under international law. All this is happening under the watch of Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte, who has not only undermined his own country's legal ruling, but even called it a mere scrap of paper. Other countries have repeatedly called on China to cease its illegal incursions. But one of the strongest statements has come from the U.S. Secretary of State, Anthony Blinken. He warned China America would defend the Philippines should there be an armed attack against its military or even its public vessels.
Many say it was a David versus Goliath scenario that proved that right is might. But years later, critics say President Rodrigo Duterte squandered that victory by refusing to enforce the ruling and even backpedaled on his campaign promise to fight for the country's rights in the South China Sea. Jamela Alindogan, Al Jazeera, Manila.